I'm surrounded by a great group of people, including Ethan Uecker.
I am pretty great, aren't I?
You are.
Thank you.
And Jeff Wagstaff.
I'm here too.
Yes. And world-renowned orthopedic surgeon, Dr. Alfred Bonatti.
Hello.
In what has become a main political priority of President Trump, new visa rules aimed at restricting birth tourism, in which women travel to the United States to give birth so their children can have U.S. citizenship, have been imposed. Mm-hmm. Joining us to discuss is former U.S. Congressman Tom Tancredo, who is also an advisory board member for We Build the Wall, a group which is using donations from private citizens to help erect the border barrier. Thank you for being here with us, Mr. Tancredo.
It's a pleasure to join you.
Yes.
Of course. Now, before we get into the developments on what's going on with the border wall, I was just reading the other day that apparently Trump has funneled money from the Department of Defense to continue and most likely finish building this wall. But let's talk about birth tourism first. Explain what that is. A lot of people have heard the term anchor baby, which is supposed to be really derogatory, I guess, which I didn't know. But explain what birth tourism is.
Because of the way in which the immigration system in the United States has developed over the years, there is the ability for someone who is born in the United States or any of its territories to be a citizen automatically as a result of that birth. Now, what happens often is that people who want to obtain citizenship for their children, and eventually, of course, they can for themselves after a period of time, will come to the United States or one of its territories and give birth and go back home, but have that as an anchor in a way. And that's what, you referred to earlier. There's a big difference between what I just described and the anchor baby of a person who has come here illegally. That's a different thing. But it's the same outcome. Having a baby on the territory of the United States, because of the interpretation, I suppose, of the 14th Amendment, the child becomes a citizen. Now, it has been, of course, taken advantage of by a lot of people who don't want to go through the process of becoming a citizen the regular way or having their children do the same. And so it is an example of what goes on. Marianas Island is a part of the United States. They're a territory. But the Chinese, for instance, do not have to have a visa to visit the Marianas. Well, there are more Chinese born in the Marianas than there are natives of the Marianas. And it's because they want that link, that citizenship issue. But that's what's called birth tourism.
But it's not even that they're just encouraging them. I mean, they're taking money. I mean, it is a business.
There was a huge ring busted, I believe, last year where there were they made millions of dollars exploiting these women, mostly from China, mm-hmm. to bring them in through California so that they could have children. And charging them up to $50,000 to bring them over here
That's
to
right.
do so. So they're being exploited on both sides.
Mm-hmm. Well, a long time ago, I remember becoming aware of a group of attorneys in the United States who had set up that business. It was primarily for people in Mexico. They would set up everything in the United States, arrange for these people to come in, have a social security number established, and all that sort of thing. There was a huge number of attorneys who had developed this as a cottage industry.
Why would other governments want to encourage their citizens to give birth here other than if they wanted to eventually infiltrate from within?
That's right. There aren't many other reasons that I can think of, especially with regard to the Chinese. I mean, the Chinese do not think of anything on a short-term basis. Their idea of policy, especially foreign policy, is based on a long-term sort of perspective. And for this purpose, they identify people who they want to come into the United States, become citizens, come back when they're 21 or even earlier, and establish themselves as citizens and bring in, of course, the parents then at that time. And so when they come in, they go into the system of higher education and become oftentimes spies for the Chinese.
Mm-hmm.
And they get into, they are industrial spies, corporate spies, political spies.
Mm-hmm. Where the Chinese are currently infiltrated our universities and our downloading the research that we pay for and taking it back
That's
to China.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Don't forget also that as soon as they are born in the country, they have all the privilege of the country. So they have privilege of free education, free health care, and all the other elements that they are going to be delivered to them. And when they deliver to them, they deliver to the parents. some of these parents are going to stay in the country, so cost to the taxpayer a tremendous amount of money.
Well, and that happens more especially with illegal immigrants who come in under the radar and have a child here, and then they are anchored here themselves because we say, well, we can't send the person back. The child is an American citizen, that sort of thing. But the anchor, the tourism, at least you have an idea of who they are, you know, because they have, in other cases, come in with a visa, come in legally, had a child here. But then this whole thing has to be, should be, debated again and adjudicated because it's never been adjudicated at the Supreme Court level. It needs to be. So I'm glad that there is this attempt on the part of the administration to push this issue, and maybe we'll get it to the Supreme Court where we actually need an interpretation of that 14th Amendment as to whether or not anyone born here deserves the advantage of citizenship, or if you are going to use what is in the Constitution as a limiting factor, and that is under the jurisdiction thereof. Those words are very important.
We should have you on again coming up to really delve into that specifically because we didn't have a chance to discuss it now.
Issue, yeah.
Well, it's going to continue to be a problem, so I'm sure we'll have you back many, many times, Mr. Tancredo.
Yes.
Happy to do so.
Former U.S. Congressman Tom Tancredo, also advisory board member for the We Build the Wall group.
He's in a hurry. He's headed down to the border. He's got stuff to do.
And we'll get an update on the wall, too, because it is being built matter what you hear from the left. Thank you for listening and watching American Medicine Today.